How's it going, boys? Today, we finally, I think this is it. We have finished the 250 self-mill deck, and it's glorious. Actually won games. Didn't get land flooded. I will say that that's probably luck, but whatever. Whatever, boys. So, this deck is one hell of a tank. We have four cards in the side deck because Mirror March, because the Risen Reef Infinity self-mill is still the literal dream of existence at this moment in time. So yeah, but most likely we're gonna self-mill by a different strategy. Okay, so this deck is one hell of a beast. It has precisely 87 lands, no special lands except two Lotus Fields, and that's pretty much it. And, well, let's get just into it. 3 Opt, 4 Revitalize, 4 Chart the Course, 3 Search for Azcanta, 4 Cast Down, 3 Moments of Craving, 2 Guys Blessings, 4 Assassins Trophies, 4 Growth Spirals, 4 Treasure Maps, 4 Divinations, 4 Narsets, 4 Gifts of Paradise, 3 Abolish, 4 Dovins, a QT, 4 Trefaris, 4 Mortifies, 3 Bedevils, 4 Deafening Clarions, 4 Risen Reefs, 4 Chromatic Lartens, 4 Ixalan's Bindings, 4 Settle the Wreckage, 4 Bonds of Insights, 4 Chemist's Insights, 4 Drowning Dreams, 4 Jace's Wielders of Something, 4 Leylines of Anticipation, 4 Mastermind's Acquisition, 4 Vraskas, 4 Wilderness Reclamations, 4 Kaizrats, 4 Tamios, 4 Karn Scions of Urza, 4 Primal Amulets, 4 Cleansing Novas, 2 J-Ballards, 4 Tefari's Heroes of Dominaria, 4 Time Wipes, 3 Floods of Tears, 4 Sunbirds Invocations, 3 Primeval Glorious Rebirth, 2 Omnipotences in all these lands, boys. And in the sideboard, we have 4 Mirror Marches. Yes, we have a sideboard, and you can't go above 250 cards. You need to have 450 cards with the sideboard included. So, we essentially even cheated, but boys, what did you honestly expect from me? So, yeah, the main way we're gonna achieve the self-milling is by a deck that you have already seen previously. It's Primeval Glorious Rebirth, combination with Tamio, Omniscience, and a Jace. Pretty easy self-milling condition, it's an infinity self-mill. Yes, we have done that. Look in my video lists and see it, it's a pretty goddamn good deck. And, you know, But the dream is that we get to the point where we drop 4 Mirror Marches, and we just play a singular Risen Reef. And we essentially completely crash and burn the European servers. That is the literal dream, boys. Oh yes. So we have a lot of draw, healing where we can get it, mana curvage expenditures and whatnot, AoE removals, and all that good stuff. So let's just go ahead, jump right into it and see what happens. And boys, my madness, it's real. We all know it. We do so much stupid things on a daily basis. And if you want to keep supporting me on doing stupid stuff on a daily basis and somehow not get reprimanded by society by it, or if you want me to get reprimanded by society by it, please like the video because that's the absolute best thing ever. So, not the best hand in the world, so we're gonna mulligan. Oh yes, we're mulliganing. Oh, Sunbird's Invocation at the opening hand. That is definitely what you call juice. Boys, and a castable Deafening Clarion, and a little bit of draw. Okay, so Sunbird's Invocation at the early stages of the game is the easiest way to actually achieve some kind of almost not randomness, you could probably say that when it comes to the deck, but we're gonna get rid of Gaia's Blessing probably because everything else is just too far in value territory. Okay, so here's the dream. Admittedly, the deck does have a significant weakness. Oh, Healing Fountains. Okay, that's something. A Jace. We can't use the Jace, but whatever. As long as we get to the Sunbird's Invocation without dying, we have a really good shot at this. So yeah, obviously we have a bunch of good combos here because all of our cards draw, they play good with Sunbird Invocations, and ooh, that's not good. Oh, that's actually still okay-ish. Yes, that is actually still okay-ish. Okay, so now we need a land. Hopefully some kind of good land. A blue land would be terrific, because then we can jace it up a little bit. Okay, let's see what he does. I really don't want the 40s to come dropping down on us. Okay, this is still good. This is still manageable. I don't care if he heals, because, well, we're a mill deck, so essentially a little bit of healing never hurt anyone, except me. A Trefari, I guess it's fine. I guess it is fine. So we're obviously minusing that, and hopefully, okay, drawing this is not bad. Again, we need to get the 6 mana, and then we can do good stuff. Admittedly, a blue mana, second blue mana, would have been the most terrific thing in the history of terrific things. But sadly, didn't happen, boys. So yeah, there we go. Okay. So currently, it's going as good as it can. It's some kind of aggro deck, but he hasn't exactly achieved the aggro-ish most parts of the deck. Let's see. I don't want to take that much damage. So I'm just going to do this instantaneously. Should be fine. Again, HP is actually one of the most limiting factors this deck has. Because all we have is essentially a couple of revitalizes and, you know, we call it a day. Okay, good. This guy looks like he's not having enough luck. Because he hasn't gotten the big boys. But admittedly, he have everything to deal with the big boys. So there you have... Oh, yes, a Rapture Spire. That is actually perfect. That is literally perfect, boys. Now we're gonna be able to drop Jace, acquire a little bit of that sweet, fluffy something-something, and we're gonna be Ley Lines of Anticipation-ing soon-ish, kind of, whatever. You know, whatever. Okay, but the Sunbird's Invocation is still the utmost play of the century. He's sacrificing a fountain, cracking some eggs. Admittedly, we're not cracking eggs in this deck, which is, honestly, in my opinion, strange for me, but hey, that's fine. Okay, time to kill this instantaneously. No waiting around the bush, because next turn we possibly will use up all our mana. Okay, so this is perfect. This is absolutely... Okay, Fifari. That's actually also pretty good. Okay. Obviously, we can, by the way, win without milling and whatnot. But again, mill is still... Oh, glaw! Oh, boys. All we need is one man. Boys. Boys. All we need is one man. Yes. I'm gonna let this survive because we technically have enough things that actually prevent and stop anything bad from happening, so this is fine. Okay, so currently, it looks like we're winning, and we are gonna win hard with the Sunbirds. Two Sunbirds Sunbirds Invocation is probably the best stuff you can ever come up with. Absolutely masterful. They're gonna establish so much dominance, it's gonna echo through the ages. Not gonna lie. Come on, a land. Just give me that land. Just give me. Just give it to me, baby. Eh, it's not the land we were looking for. Okay, so first of all, maybe we top deck a land that's actually better. Yes! It's so goddamn over for this guy. Holy boys. 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 We're doing it. We're doing it like there's no goddamn tomorrow. Oh, Sunbird's Invocation on top of a... Oh, please. You're a Johnny's Pride Mate. Literally will not achieve the slightest shred of whatever the hell it's supposed to achieve. It's done. Sunbird's Invocation is dropped and ready to go. I'm probably gonna find something the Sunbird's Invocation... Actually, no, I don't drop the ley lines. Okay, whatever. It doesn't really matter. Oh, this is gonna be glorious. Oh yeah, that's a really big Johnny's Pride Mate you have there. Too bad it doesn't matter at all. Too bad it doesn't matter at all. Okay, so we're gonna do this, obviously. And now we're dropping the Sun's Bird Invocation on the Sun's Bird Invocation. And we got an Ixalan's Binding, boys. Say goodbye to your filthy 40s. Oh yeah. So, what is exactly the plan now, enemy-kun? Oh, that's right, there is no plan. You are at my mercy, and my mercy is not the best of mercies, not gonna lie. Oh, another Johnny's welcome. Okay, he can't kill that. He can create tokens, which is gonna be, like, really annoying. But at the... Well, he's also gonna draw... Oh my god! If he cleansing knows me, I'm gonna scream and cry. There is no question about that. Okay, so currently it's going as good as it can go. He's attacking. Wait, you're attack. Oh, I thought he's gonna only attack once. But yeah, two Sunbirds invocations. We're paying life for this to establish maximum chedarity. So let's just do this and see what we get. A primal amulet, you say? Okay, we're gonna drop this in hopes that we find a Wilderness Reclamation. I didn't find a Wilderness Reclamation, but it's fine. At least we're getting something then. Oof! Destroy artifact, yes. Oh wait, that's not an artifact. Wait, cancel? Chart the course? Probably is better than... Okay, yes, chart the course was not actually that bad. Okay, we don't need that many primal amulets. Okay, so now we're gonna also do this, because we want to find certain things. Again, a Wilderness Reclamation above... Oh, okay. Okay, we finally found it. A Mortify. That's good. That is really, really good. Ah, and here we have it, boys. A Wilderness Reclamation with the Ley Lines combo. Oh, boys. We are achieving stuff. And I'm not gonna lie, that stuff is gonna be... It's gonna be... Pretty goddamn impressive. First, I want to do this, honestly. Okay, so let's just do it like this. And let's just play the Revitalize. Sunbird Invocation two times. On 2 mana, it's probably not going to find anything relevant. But, well, who cares at that point, honestly. Okay, and now we Wilderness Reclamation. And we play this. And let's see what we actually get. Oh, boys. So, okay. Currency on the Forzes here. That's pretty good. Okay, let's see now. search for Azcanta is definitely up there. But Dovin's... search for Azcanta. Let it be. Let it be, boys. Search for Azcanta. And now the Jace. I think he's gonna surrender. There's no... Tamio. Tamio's pretty good. I actually have no idea what the plus one with Tamio. That's like the only problem, honestly, I see in this deck. I have absolutely no clue what the hell I'm supposed to Tamio for plus one. It seems a little bit redundant. But yeah. Actually. No, there's nothing in the deck. Well, guess it's gonna be Primordial. Oh, no. I will Tamio for Tamio, and then I'm gonna Tamio for Primeval Rebirth. That's gonna be fine. Well, first we're gonna Jace it up, but yeah. So, Exelon's Binding? Are you gonna Exelon's Binding my Exelon's Binding? The absolute mad lad. Actually, no, but close enough. Okay, so let's see. Getting more Wilderness Reclamations with Sunbirds. Well, you have actually seen the Spellslinger. If you haven't also seen the Spellslinger deck, again... the Tamio Infinity Mill and Sunbird's Invocation Spellslinger decks are some of the best decks I have made by far, probably. So yeah, you should probably check them out if you haven't. So that's a thing. Oh, he's going for the Tamio. Oof. That's a very bold move, Cotton. Okay, so there goes that. We can technically find... We can find so many things here that absolutely... Risen Reef. Boys, you just don't pass a Risen Reef like that. Okay, so let's do this. Yes, that was fine. And an Assassin's Throne. Yeah, that's also fine. Okay. So we're looking for a Tamio Collector of Tales. Let's see, can we find... Oh, that was... Okay, that was... Yeah, he just surrenders! He just surrenders! Well, obviously, he surrenders, like, 250-card deck, and you're not gonna surrender after not winning instantly. Chances are a 250-card deck has absolutely the solution for anything and everything, so, yeah. You're probably surrendering. Yeah, it's... I'm probably not gonna get the Risen Reef combo to... Oof. This looks... This has so much potential. Ah, why does it have to be two gateway plazas? Okay, 246, four gateway plazas. Oh, that's a huge oof. That's a huge oof to draw two of the same cards in the deck like that. Okay, well, none the matter. We need to mulligan. Okay, this is honestly as good as it's gonna get. We have Tommy... Well, we have almost the full mill combo. Jesus Christ, boys. Gonna get rid of Jace, though. We're gonna find him no matter what, so it's honestly technically a little bit whatever. Okay. Oh, it's a vampire deck. Flood of Tears is definitely not the best card. Okay, this was a bad, relatively bad hand. Let's see how lucky this guy is. Yeah, this guy's pretty fucking lucky. Okay, great stuff. You most likely... I kind of need mana a little bit more than anything else, game. Okay, so what exactly... Oh, and Legion's Landing for perpetual annoyance. We're probably dead this game, yeah. Well, this is as good as it's gonna get, probably. Okay, so what are we gonna do? Well, we're gonna minus this, obviously. Well, we could minus the token, but then he can place... Okay! Is this actually... No, this is not Kaya's Vrat castable portions of mana, boys. Shit. Okay, do this. He can also get rid of our things. He's probably gonna get rid of the Trefari, because that's what scares people. But honestly, it's a little bit of overreaction when you play against Trefaris. Should have probably done the minus on the token so it disappears. But honestly, it's... Okay. Is there a chance where we win? Chemist's Insight is probably our best bet, sadly. This is not the winning color scheme of anything. Okay, well, this was sad. But, you know, it's a vampire deck that got pretty goddamn lucky. This is a very... Well, this is probably the strongest starting hand card for them, but, you know. A little bit not there. A little bit not there. We missed a little bit. But just a little bit. It's fine, boys. It's absolutely fine. God. So, if you haven't seen also the Risen Reef Madness of Replication... It almost completely shut down the servers the moment, you know, it just worked, essentially. The Lotus Fields. Leyline's Anticipation, Vasquez, you go first, I guess this is it. Yeah, Primeval Glorious Rebirth is not the best. Okay, we need two lands. If we do that, we can potentially salvage it. But again, so the biggest problem is obviously lands. Submit, that's pretty good. But yeah. Actually, currently dropping this and playing that, this guy probably thinks he's in an enormous disadvantage. Can't really blame the fuck, but hey. We know the truth, boys. We know the truth. Please be some kind of up. Oh. Even in a 250 card deck, the game still will prioritize giving you those, rare, unique lands. It's absolutely insane, in my opinion. Oh, and this is another vampire deck? Really? Oh, come on! Give me a land. Okay, mandatory comment about cutting the amount of lands or increasing the amount of lands or something like that. Yes, I know, boys, I know. Deck needs more or... Ah, come on! Okay, we're getting rid of this. We can still salvage. We can still salvage. It's gonna be tough, not gonna lie, boys, but we can still salvage. Why is Lotus Field also... Well, if it didn't enter tapped, it would be a little bit broken. But yeah, and this guy is just... Man, look at this cunt. Three lands versus my... Four lands versus my zero lands. Yeah, come on. Don't do this. Oh, come on. I'm concede. Yeah. Well, again, if that happens, it just happens. In a 60-card deck, lands are a problem. And if lands happen to become a problem in a 250-card deck, you obviously, it's going to be even a bigger problem if you get unlucky or land flooded or land starved. So, yeah. So, let's see what this is. Also, we're playing up against aggro decks, probably the more annoying versions. Okay, so here we have four lands, and we start with an Opt and a Narset. That's pretty cheeky. Okay, so how are we gonna do it? Watery Grave, it seems like, is gonna be the play. Okay, have some AoE removal. That's good, that's good. Have a Narset, have four lands, have a Vras, because that's playable. Risen Reef, boys. Oh, even this. Yes, yes, yes. I will actually take that. That's gonna completely fix any mana problems I ever had in my filthy life. Also, what the hell is... Oh, it's a Birds deck. Okay, that's actually completely feasible and dealable with. Okay, so suddenly the issue with mana has been alleviated to, well, pretty much the rest of the game. Good stuff. We can cast Time Wipe, but we can, more importantly, we can cast Risen Reef and, well, a little bit also. Hey, what is this? I'm not sure I know what that deck is. Not 100% sure, but... Okay. Okay, game. That was pretty cheeky, not gonna lie. Okay. So, let's see. It is an elemental deck, but... An elemental like that, deck like that, is not currently looking like the biggest thing in the whole universe. Okay, that's actually useful. That is actually useful. So let's do this. Sunbird's Invocation. A Tameo. And a Binding. I'm actually gonna just Binding this because it's a Risen Reef. Perfect Binding, boys. Perfect Binding. Okay, so that's as far as we... Well, that's actually as good of a turn as you would ever get. So, Risen Reef plus Time Wipe, obvious synergy, by the way, if anyone did not notice. Oh yeah, it's... Wait, is it time to kill everything? Or is it not time to just yet kill... Ah, yes, we can wait. We can wait one more turn. Oh, wait, he did not. Okay, so that means he's playing something big. Most likely something big in the sense that I don't care about it too much. Oh no, he's gonna play it now. Ah, damn it! That's really, really, really annoying. Not gonna lie, boys, that's actually annoying. Okay, but it's fine, it's fine. So this turn we're gonna do Vraska's. We hope for a land and we can drop Risen Reef. That's essentially the dream currently, right? Well, Vraska's in a treasure map on its own is not actually that bad. So we got rid of that, which is really annoying, so that's good. And now we can do this. Okay, so that's as good as that turn could have possibly gone, because we fully expanded our map. Yes, good, good, good. More, yes, yes, enemy-chan. Yes, 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 yes! Drop all your big stuff. Make me proud. Actually, I'm a little bit afraid of using this because Time Wipe is not gonna be. Okay, wait, can we use. Five. Yes, we can still use Time Wipe. Perfect, excellent. Sunbird's Invocation, boys. Sunbird's Invocation has been found. Oh, it's gonna be glorious. As long as he does not drop a Carnage Tyrant, technically we're gonna be 100% your boy. Wait, what? He's gonna steal a shit. Okay, that's not even that bad. That is not even that bad. Admittedly, I hate people who randomly just put Agents of Treachery in their decks for no reason. But good, it's good enough. It's good enough. Okay, so Sunbird's Invocation is not being stopped anymore. We're dropping a Narset and we're dropping a Risen Reef. We're searching two times for three, we can most likely kill that. And hopefully he doesn't... Yarok! Okay, game. If you drop another Agent of Treachery, I'm gonna scream. What? Hello? Is that some kind of bad joke? Do I want the Dovin's Acuity? Let's see, Demon. Yes, I can play Dovin's Acuity by playing Narset. Okay, so let's do this. Actually, Mortify is far better. Okay, at least this happened in the... at least this worked out for us. So let's see, there's still nothing we can get out with Primeval Glorious Rebirth. Oh, that agent, man! Why the hell do you use Nature's End? Are you absolutely insane, Arafakun? The hell is wrong with you? Random Agents of Treachery splash in Nature's End. Fuck you! Kill yourself, even. Piece of shit! Okay! Yeah, I kinda had a feeling that that's honestly gonna happen because of the Yarok and whatnot, but I was kinda hoping that, you know, it's not gonna happen. More treasure maps. Sadly, we can't exactly go for more treasure maps. More lotterns. Not the dream, but hey, at least it's something. It will fix the mana for a bit, and here's the Risen Reef. Vraska's Contempt. Honestly, not even that bad. Oh, that Sunbird's Invocation kill. Oh, that's so painful. I hate people who have just randomly Agents of Treachery for no goddamn reason at all. And yes, of course, you have the second... Why do you even play Nature's End, you piece of shit, filth? I'm actually pissed. Oh, and he now gets double Risen Reef. Oh, look at me, I'm playing a 60-card deck, it's a little bit more no one cares. Oh, but third Risen Reef, what a champion, boys, what an absolute champion. Oh, just play a Risen Reef, an Agent of Tra- Man, Risen Reef, still, ban this card, it's- Oh, okay. So, I have a 250 goddamn card deck, right? Right? Okay, I can't do anything here. Okay, so 250 goddamn card deck. And by the way, notice I am still using Risen Reefs. Can you imagine why? It's because they're completely batshit overpowered. That's how simple it is. That's how simple it is. Okay, so there is a chance that we get to do something, right? Man! If only that Sunbird's Invocation wasn't cucked. Wait, what is he doing? Hello? Hello? Enemy-kun? Okay. Think that there's something's gonna... Well, he probably should honestly... Well, he should expect something to happen, right? Okay, there's no reason to even, you know, do anything remotely smart with that. Okay, you have four cards. Flood of Tears. Great stuff, Enemy-kun. Great stuff. Yes, amazing. 10 out of 10, blah, blah, blah. Agents of Treachery again. How about you just go and kill yourself? God! Playing random agents... We literally got to play against a counter deck. We somehow magically managed to play against a counter deck. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. Okay, there is no, that we have only 6 HP. There's no way he even decks himself. Okay, yeah, good stuff, boys, good stuff. Okay, so play that tapped, do this, and we can still play the Risen Reef, so... Oh, yippee, boys, yippee. There is still a chance that we somehow magically still manage to do things. A land, at least that's fine. Okay. But yeah, seriously, this is, well, it's just a deck with Risen Reefs. I guess you can't really call a deck with just Risen Reefs an exact counter, but it's close enough. Like, but the Risen Reef is an overpowered card, there's no way around it, look at this crap. God, I wish we could just burn the servers down. If you achieve this combo and, by the way, mill 200 cards in a singular glorious turn of a singular Risen Reef... Oh, Jace? So he's a mill deck? I'm a mill deck. You disgust me by playing these cards and, you know, your heresy. Well, I guess it's his choice to be a complete heretic. Okay, boys. So, it looks like this is it. We can't win this one because we can't have omniscience and we can't have all of those good things happen, blah blah blah. We actually can go also infinited just from the sheer virtue of having two Narsets, two Tamios, and omniscience out at the field. That will actually just win instantaneously also, if anyone's wondering. Because then we can just, you know, get primeval glorious rebirth back with Tamio every turn and use Narset every turn. So, you know, it's a thing. It's essentially a thing. So, yeah. This guy is pretty annoying. Playing random agents of treachery. Yes, well, play random agents of treachery. God, imagine how lucky you need to be for that to happen, though. Hello there. Huh. Draws one, he discards. Okay. Let's go for this play. Maybe we actually can win. Maybe he decides that he needs to increase the length of his internet PP. So, 5 cards. Mills 2. No. Does that. Oh no, he's not doing it. He's gonna draw with the Agent of Treachery. Damn it! I was hoping he wants to, like, do it the way that he has 0 cards, and then we just Trefari him to infinity and beyond like real Chads, but not happening, boys, not happening. Let's... Okay, that still does not win the game, by the way. Okay, he's doing that on purpose. He's doing that on purpose. And the Risen Reefs don't proc the win condition. So now the please flip the turn back to me. Please flip. Ah! What a spoil sport. Winged World, by the way, is a horrible card. I have no idea why he's even rolling with it. But yeah. Oh, that was. Man, the last game. It could have gone so well, but no. He just randomly has Agents of Goddamn Treachery. And he randomly just already drew the only card that probably kills enchantments. He can do so much with Sunbird's Invocation. Where is it? Here it is. Sunbird's Invocation, such an amazingly powerful card. Especially in decks like this, you know? Especially in decks in situations like this. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So, this was the deck. It's actually pretty good now, and it can win to a fairly consistent degree games. All you need to do is not mulligan the first hand, draw a little bit of lands, and you know, then the deck kind of plays itself. So yeah. So this was Quasar77. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Check out my channel, check out the Discord, check out the Patreon, check out the everything, and have a nice day. Bye-bye. Like the video, please do. Like, that helps a lot. Also, I'm gonna be finally promoting the Patreons who actually patronaged, because we have a problem. Too many people are choosing to be tier 3 Patreons, and that means a lot of mods, which is not exactly the greatest thing in the world, but hey. So yeah, bye-bye!